Hi, I'm Colleen, DIYer behind lemonthistle.com. Today, I'm going to show you how to add a punch of color to standard wooden kitchen goods. For this project, you'll need your kitchen goods. I've chosen a cutting board and wooden spoons. You'll need paint brushes and multi-surface acrylic paint, painter's tape, and walnut oil for finishing the wood. You'll want to start by taping off the areas that you'd like to paint. For the wooden spoons, I'm going to tape off part of the handle to give it a dipped look. And for the cutting board, I'm going to tape so I just paint the edges. Make sure to press your tape down so that no paint leaks underneath. For the cutting board, my cutting board has a handle, so you'll want to remove any hardware that's in the area that you're going to paint, just so that you don't have to tape around all these little details. Now you can start taping. I'm not going to tape the rounded corners. I'm just going to leave those open and paint really carefully when I get to the edges. Now we can start painting. It might take a couple coats to get the brightness of color that you're looking for. When you're all done your painting, while the paint is still damp, go ahead and peel back your tape to make sure that no paint has gotten underneath. When your paint is all dry, you're ready to reattach your hardware. My cutting board came with this hard plastic handle, which I didn't love, so I'm replacing it with a leather strap. When your cutting board is reassembled and your spoons are completely dry, you'll want to seal them so that they're good for food use and so that your paint doesn't wear as quickly. This will need to be done regularly when you notice that your spoons or cutting board is looking a little bit rough. If your utensils haven't been sealed before, as these wooden spoons haven't, you can apply a little bit more generously, as it'll soak it up pretty quickly. This would make a great housewarming gift, a bridal shower gift, or even a gift for yourself in the everyday.